And we're back.
Hi, my name's Chris.
I'm Gano.
And we're playing Dark Souls.
Yep.
Number and trois.
Yeah.
Eight.
Trez.
Fa.
That's not three.
What's trois?
Three.
Well then, why am I confused?
Because I'm a stupid.
What's trois?
It's three.
In what language?
French.
Then what's a tray?
I don't. It's another one.
It's also a man's name.
I think it's 13. People speak French.
Well, what's three in Spanish? Uno, dos, tres. It's tres. And what's tray? That looks. Are we gonna die here? Looks very ominous.
Not if we're fucking heroes.
Not if we book it.
Not if we just fucking do this one at a time.
Wait, they have fire. Are they weak to fire?
No.
So then what's the plan here?
Well, fucking doing this. Yeah!
This isn't, yeah! This isn't working at all.
Yeah!
This is horrible.
You can't do anything. Oh, well, yeah!
You got that guy.
Oh, I'm so fucking good.
I mean, you got him. We don't need those fire bombs, right?
You can just buy more. So fucking good this game.
Oh, fa wiener.
Oh shit, got claymore. I didn't know they could drop that. Huh.
Is that good?
Yeah, it's an okay weapon, but just like I didn't know they could drop it.
So, is our firebomb tactic gonna work with that guy that's up there?
I didn't expect it to work in the first place. I just kinda did it and hoped for the best.
You keep trading blows with these guys. So you like science things, right, Keanu?
Of course.
So there's this YouTube channel called The Nerdist.
Yeah.
Or Nerdist.
Mm-hmm.
And he does there's this one guy that I like. He's like, he has really long hair and stuff. But he does this show about.
Oh, that guy.
Oh, shit, yeah. He does, like, just sciencey stuff about, like, fiction and, like, comic books. There's just one that I know pretty well where he talks about that if Wolverine is the height they say he is in, like, the comics, with the adamantium, how, like, the claws come out of him, they're so long that he wouldn't actually be able to move his wrist. And, like, it's just weird to be like, oh, shit, I never really thought of that. But, like, I was talking to my dad about it, of, like, how I think this is really cool. And then he says, like, oh, so there's people out there that ruin movies? And I'm just like, well, I mean, like, it's not ruining it. I think it's, like, interesting to be like, oh, cool. Like, that wouldn't be able to happen. Or, like, he goes into, like, because Wolverine's on, like, 5'3", right?
Yeah.
But he was saying, like, if he was, like, 6'3", then he'd be able to, like, work his, like, wrist fine, right?
Yeah.
Which is, like, almost the height of, like, Hugh Jackman, so I think the movies are fine.
Yeah.
I think he was just mainly saying, like, the comic books are kind of, like, he would have to be, like, 9'3 or, like, 8'3 in order for him to move his, like, whole arm and, like, have, like, the claws be no problem.
Yeah.
Which I thought was, like, oh, that's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. But, like, a lot of, like, I mean, I've admitted this to you a couple times, though, where, like, sometimes you'll talk about, like, really heavy, like, calculations and, like, science stuff. I'm like, at the end, I'm like, oh, that's pretty cool. Like, during the process, yeah. I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah.
Where are these numbers coming from? And, like, a lot of this guy's episodes, too, are just like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
But then at the end, he's like, yeah, and that's how you can find out if someone's a werewolf. I'm like, that was pretty cool. it's like, ah, oh, jeez.
Yeah. It's like, what were we talking about? I think it was last episode. Oh, yeah, Kingdoms of Amalur.
Yeah.
It's honestly, like, one of my favorite. Like, Mark O is always like, oh, like, Wind Waker's, like, this game I play, like, once a year, and, like, it's one of my favorite games of all time. It's, like, that for me. Or,
that's
like,
your Wind Waker?
Yeah, like, that's my Wind Waker. Like, a lot of people give the game crap, and they're like, oh, this game's not that good, and, like, the studio got, like, just demolished after its, like, game creation, because it just didn't do well enough.
We actually talked about that today with some friends.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, EA fucking killed it.
Yeah, nothing positive. It's just like shitting on like, oh yeah, it did horrible and it was like badly received and like, oh, I feel bad.
Yeah, but I love
Keanu
it.
Keeps talking about it.
Oh, I love it. It's But yeah, like, I don't know, like, there's so many cool mechanics and everything, and, like, the customization and combo system. I don't know, I like it. And the story's pretty good, too. So there's an asshole.
There's all...
Right.
Which one is he?
There, I think. It's, like, that one, or, like, this one, or something.
He's the statue?
There's a statue here.
I'm gonna say the one that's right in front of you.
I think it's, yeah, it's, like, one of these ones. Anyway, it's the assassin to kill Anri. And we're gonna let the assassino do that.
Wait, we're letting them kill someone?
Yeah, we want the good ending. We want the dark ending.
We do?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's the best ending.
Oh.
Yeah.
Does everyone agree with that, or is that just your opinion?
I mean, it's kind of like everyone agrees with it. It's like quote unquote the true ending in a way.
I mean, I think that's kind of cool though, because like a lot of I know with some games like that have a sequel that have also multiple endings. They're like, oh well, this game stems off from you going this route.
Yeah.
Which kind of takes away, like, the choice in the previous game, where it's just like, you can do whatever you want, but, like, this is what our canon is, so, like, you're still wrong, and then it's like, oh.
Okay. Yeah. I
oh, shit, that has range.
You, like, track me. I'm gonna go sit down the bonfire back here. We're gonna go level up some stuff and read some stuff.
Oh, like we're going back to base?
Yeah, we'll do that.
Nice.
We'll do that. We've earned it. We've earned it.
Yeah, I mean, we're 6 minutes in.
Yeah.
What's upstairs? Can we even get there?
Yeah, we can go up there.
Is it, like, fancy stuff?
Yep.
Nice.
I don't remember. Is that... I'm gonna get to the boss. See, there's a boss right around here that where you can fight. We're gonna upgrade our stuff first. That way we don't get totally...
destroyed.
Just riggedy-wrecked.
Probably for the best.
Probably for the best. But yeah. What were we just talking about?
Kingdoms of Amalur.
Oh yeah, Kingdoms of Amalur.
That was your Wind Waker.
Yeah, so... I don't know. I love it. The story's pretty good. I like the combat system a lot.
Yeah, I mean, like, you were really hype about that when we were talking about it, like, a couple weeks ago.
I just found out that, like, you can magic cancel the greatsword.
Oh.
So, yeah.
When did this game come out?
2012.
Okay. And you're still learning stuff about it.
Well, yeah, because, like, I don't know, because, like...
Like, you have this game, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was playing it last night.
So I think Mark was showing me, like, a picture of, like, the menu screen, I think, from you.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh.
But yeah, like, yeah, I was playing last night, and then... Yeah, so I found out you can magic cancel the great sword. If you do like if you press block and attack with the great sword, you do like an overhead like swing, and then like you follow it up with a second overhead swing.
Yeah.
And when the second overhead swing connects, as soon as it like connects, or like any part during the animation other than like the very like recovery part of it, you can like cancel it into a magic move.
Okay.
So
you can like just wreck shop.
Yeah, which so you can like reset the combo and everything like that, or like against enemies that like don't get because like certain enemies can't be juggled, but you can like stun them,
like bigger boss kind of things.
Yeah, like trolls and stuff. Like you can't juggle them, but like you can hit them enough and like they kind of like get stunned and fall over.
Yeah.
So you can like magic cancel the combo into like a very like high damage like magic attack.
Mm-hmm.
And then like, keep the combo going after it, because a lot of the magic moves don't have like a long recovery.
Okay.
Especially like the rogue ones.
So I was looking into like, like after our talk, I was looking a lot into it, like watching all these videos and stuff.
Yeah.
So like, there's different like races.
Yep.
Is that like always like a gimmick thing with games, or do you generally like picking like a variety?
So we've talked about this like for D&D and everything.
Yeah.
I always play human.
Because they're like...
The one exception to me playing always human is fucking Kingdoms of Amalur. Oh, okay. Because all of the humans look fucking terrible.
What do
like,
you mean?
They're just like these horrible monstrosities of just like, what is this? So I play Elf in that game because they don't look horrible. They actually look okay. Because
like, I know for D&D, like they get like an extra skill or something, right?
Yeah, you get like extra stuff.
Like
for,
a saving throw?
Like every race has like its own like benefits.
Mm-hmm.
So like the race I usually pick, like they get like... They get, like, stealth and sagecraft as, like, two starting skills, which I don't use, but they get, like, a magic regen race bonus.
So it's like a bonus?
Yeah, so that's pretty okay. But like, they just don't look horrible, so that's why I play them.
That's really dumb of me. You're like, they get like a mana bonus, like, so it's like a bonus. But I meant like a bonus of like, oh yeah, sweet, but like, it doesn't make sense because it's already called mana bonus, so it's like, fuck.
Yeah, no, it's like a, they just get like a mana bonus. Like, like it's a mana regen bonus.
Okay.
Which is, you know, it's useful, it's very useful, because like, normally, unless you have like an ability or like an item, your health and mana don't regen normally. Okay. They don't regen by themselves. You have to use like potions and stuff.
You said it's not like ridiculous, right? It's just like,
yeah,
like a slight help.
Yeah, like they're there to like improve the combat system and like be like a big, like, it depends on like the spells you have. Like currently, my current build with it is I have this one ability which like it's like an always active one, and basically so what it does is it makes it so my weapon does poison damage. Like has like a 20% chance to do like 60 poison damage over 5 seconds.
Okay.
And then it also has, I have another thing, like I have like a gem where like it makes my poison damage do more. And then like I have a weapon that also does poison damage. Like I can rack up a bunch of poison damage. And like there's like damage types and everything, so certain enemies have like resistance to certain types, so it's always good to have like at least 2 different types of like weapons.
Is poison like a good one though?
It's pretty good. It's, okay. Like, most things aren't resistant to it unless they are, like, poison themselves. Like, spiders, not so much, okay. But most things, yeah, it's effective against. So I have, like, that one. I have, like a dagger throw. And then I have, I think it's called, like, Relentless Assault or something like that. It's a warrior, like, one, so you, you like shrug off blows, so like as you're fighting, like you don't take stun damage, like you don't
like knock back and
yeah
stuff.
You don't get knocked back or anything, so you can just keep attacking through it all.
Nice.
It only lasts like, the level I have it now lasts for like 16 seconds.
Okay, that's a freaking lot.
Yeah, it's a lot. So we're gonna read this stuff.
I think we had another level up too.
We're close.
I think we're like 10 off.
Yeah. So let's see. Pyromancy discovered from the abyss. By High Lord Wolnir that inspired the Black Arts of the Grave Wardens. The Grave Wardens are the dudes in the place.
Okay.
Be it sorcery or pyromancy, all techniques that infringe on humanity lead to the same place. That is to say, they all seek a will of their own. So, like, they, like, track down, like, your enemy. So that's kind of explaining, like, why they tracked him down, because, like, they're seeking out the person.
Okay.
That's
the boss sword, right?
It was his sword. So when he fell to the abyss, he was gripped by fear of true darkness and pleaded to the gods for the first time. This holy sword, together with 3 armlets that we destroyed,
okay,
stripped from the corpse of the clerics, gave him some semblance of comfort. So yeah, he was not a good person.
But we can actually get that, right?
Yeah, but we're never going to use it, so we're going to do another thing.
Okay. I noticed there's another guy up there, too. Like, I think that's the guy we fought, right? It's like some guy behind a chair, I think.
Up there?
Yeah.
I know we haven't fought him. He's like part of a...
I mean, I'm pretty sure, like, I can't really see him, but I'm pretty sure we probably talked to
a dude
up there before. Little Bobby Souls.
Mm-hmm.
Rubbish.
Gutter trash. Do we have enough? I don't remember.
I'm like, I think we...
Oh, shit. We got enough.
Yeah.
All right. Let's, some more damage.
Strong like ox.
Yes.
What's the attunement slot mean?
It's magic.
Okay.
It also increases, like, our blue bar. It also increases that.
Okay.
It's actually quicker to, like, just talk to the maiden and sell the souls, but whatever. Like, I'm not gonna let a game tell me what to do.
My game, you, I mean, game.
People.
Yeah, screw this.
Yeah. And we got enough.
Jesus.
Should we do health?
Sure. I mean, sometimes we'll get butt tickled and it hurts a lot.
You're not wrong.
I mean, is level 51 big in this game?
No.
How, like, what's the... Is there a cap?
Not really. Like, just after a while, it's gonna get hard until you do New Game Plus.
Okay.
We're gonna just drink his soul real quick.
From what I've heard for New Game Plus, though, like, it gets, like, really difficult. Like, the enemies get harder, but you get more souls and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, everything gets harder, but, like, at the same time, like, it's not too much harder. Everything just kind of has, like, more health.
But it's just more incentive to not, like, keep grinding out the first save file when you can, like, make a new game?
I mean, there's, like, benefits to getting New Game Plus. Like, so you can get, like, certain weapons that you didn't get the first time. Things like that.
Okay. Are you still worried about not getting through that place?
No, we should be okay for the most part.
You just want to squeeze everything out, though, if we try
to get the most we can out of this stuff. We're not going to use any of this stuff.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
How much grinding do you do in this game?
Me?
Like, personally, yeah.
Not as much as, like, some other games, like Monster Hunter. Like, I have over 100 hours into Monster Hunter currently.
That's a lot of grinding hours?
Most of it's grinding hours, yeah. Like, because Justin's technically a higher level than me.
Okay.
But I have way better equipment. Because, yeah. Like, I was like, I'm gonna grind as hard as I can to get all the best weapons that I can for this level. And just did that for a while.
As soon as you got me, like, that one armor set,
yeah,
it was just like uphill from there, and I was doing like all the quests, and I think I say now I finally hit the point where like I'm having difficulty, but now is like months ago or like a few weeks ago where it was just like I put down the game to do other stuff and I haven't picked stuff yet.
Yeah,
like again, it's kind of sad because like I had a lot of fun, I just stopped playing it for some reason.
Because
I know you got like that a bit and then picked it up recently, right?
Yeah, because I didn't have internet for a while, so I was just, like, playing all through all the things that, like, I haven't played in a while. And that was one of them. It was good. It was nice to play it again.
Are you in the new place?
Yeah, I'm fully moved in.
Oh.
Yeah, so I live, like, right down the road from Mark now.
Weird.
I know. I also found out that my grandfather poops naked.
pretty cool stuff.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
I mean, I think when you, like, when it's your own house, you're just like, ah, whatever.
I mean, like, yeah, it's his house. He can, I guess, do whatever he wants, really.
Do you ever get like that, though?
Poop naked?
Yeah.
I mean, like, once or twice. Right?
Yeah. Can you imagine, like, setting you up, and then you're like, yeah, I agree. And like, I fucking lied. I'm not like that at all. That's weird. You're like,
oh, okay.
Yeah, only 10 souls for that thing.
No. We're going to sell the Pope hat.
We have two of those mask things. I know it's only 10 souls, but we have two of them.
Yeah. We'll just leave them in the inventory forever, just so like people can complain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're the one mask that gives you crap stats to look cool.
Mm-hmm. So no. Do you want to level up?
I don't know. More health. More health. Yes. Right. Excellent.
Alright, look at that. Look at all that health. Look at it all.
A snap.
You looking at it?
Just like...
Are you looking at the health bar, Chris?
I mean, no, that's gone.
Well, shit, you missed your chance.
Fuck. I'll never be able to see it again.
Mm-hmm.
Does it, like, reach all, like, to the rest of the screen, though?
It reaches pretty far.
Like, gets to the end and then, like, loops around the whole, like, screen.
It's, like, all, like, squiggly and shit. Yeah. Like, can't see anything.
It's like Snake, so when it hits the end, it needs to go around another loop. And, like, your area of vision gets smaller and smaller the more health you have.
It seems like a hindrance more than a...
It makes the game harder if you want all that health.
Yeah.
You gotta work for it. So, up the stairs or down where those guys were?
I think we want to go up the stairs.
Are you sure?
Probably. Is there anything up here? Never mind.
Okay. I thought... Well, yeah, secret? Secret?
I don't think there is. I think this is just like an empty room.
It's pretty weird. But why?
I don't know.
Okay.
Dude. Because they're probably going to do a DLC thing later, honestly.
It's like, oh, the door was there the whole time, kind of.
Like, I mean, they've done that, like, Dark Souls 2, they did that.
Where Resident Evil, like, things.
Yeah, Dark Souls 2 did it, where it's like, oh, yeah, by the way, like, this thing is,
is a thingy.
Yeah.
Were we here before?
Kinda. Kinda. We were, like, right over there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is this where we're supposed to go, though?
We could have done something here.
Did we miss a chance?
Yeah, remember I said, like, that summon thing? There would have been a guy over here we can fight.
Okay.
But we may not be able to do it, but we can fight Crichton, who was from Dark Souls 2.
I was about to ask if it was this guy, but I'm pretty sure it's not this guy.
No, it's not.
Because he looks exactly like everyone else.
Yeah.
I think you missed an item back there, too.
Probably.
It's right by that, yeah. Best weapon! Best weapon in the game! Oh.
Fading soul.
Close.
That 50 souls, though. Yeah, you never know if that 50 souls is going to come in handy.
Close second, right?
Yeah, I mean, you know. Yeah, I'm not going to sneeze at 50 souls, you know. If someone handed me $50, you know, I wouldn't sneeze at it.
Like, what does that even mean?
Like, I mean,
like,
you know.
Like, what?
You don't sneeze at it, you know. Not going to be like, achoo.
But it's not, like, is that a rude thing to forcefully sneeze when someone's giving you money?
I mean, like, yeah, it's like, you know, like, fuck you, I'm gonna sneeze at you, you know?
No, I don't.
You know?
I'm just getting more confused.
You know? Do you know, Chris?
I don't!
You know?
You were doing that earlier to Mark. And then he just had a sneezing fit, and then we were just like, you know what? We'll talk about this later.
Like, I was like, you know what, Mark? Do you know what? Do you know why? And he started like blowing his nose a bunch, and then like coughed a bunch, and then sneezed, and just looked like death. And I was like, "Well, we'll come back to this one, Mark. Rusted gold coin, worth it."
We gave him some Kleenex.
I mean, we've fucking done nothing this episode. Yeah. Oh well.
We talked about a lot in the home base.
Yeah, I mean, like, I feel like. There's something up here.
Shit on my face. Not here.
I didn't think there was anything there.
Someone else. We also gave him some tissue, though. And I asked, like, hey, you want anything else? He's like, the cold embrace of death. I'm like, oh.
That's really depressing.
Yeah. Anyway, we're going to record a video. So yeah.
Shit.
God, I thought that dead body was, like, attacking you.
You thought that dead body wasn't a dead body?
Yeah.
Don't hate that happens. And like, yeah. You're like, oh, hey, dead body. And it's an alive body. And you're like, well, now I'm just mad.
Now I regret digging up this grave. What the fuck?
Yeah. It happens to me every second Wednesday of the month.
Those are a lot of invisible enemies.
I don't think there's anything good in that chest up there.
Come on. Do we have to go past here, though?
Yeah.
You just thinking about a game plan? Oh, enemy. Oh. Ooh. That happened a lot in Silent Hill, where, like, we would go through a door, but, like, the loading animation to, like, get through the door would give, like, opportunity for the enemies, so they could actually take away health as we're, like, opening a door. It's like, what? Oh, he can climb ladders. Okay.
Yep. It's the next evolution of enemy, Chris. Ladders.
Like, oh, God. Oh, fuck. Where did they even come from?
I don't know.
They went, like, through a wall.
Yep.
Oh, God.
Just gonna be a coward, Chris. Just be a coward.
Oh, God.
You wanna get through life? Be a coward.
Is this... Did we fuck up?
Nope.
Okay. Oh, okay. Then on the other side. That was one of those, like, you drop down and we were, like, in a past place we weren't supposed to be. I'm like, oh, shit.
Fucking stop being invisible. God.
Sorry.
You just, like, tried not being invisible and sneaking up on me? I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I prefer if you weren't.
Oh, God. Okay. The whole thing with superpowers, right?
Yeah.
Like Iceman, right? He, like, shoots ice out of his hands. That's
Wait,
one
really?
Of... Yeah, yeah, that's one of his powers. I don't know if you know this. But, like...
Wait, so you're telling me Iceman is ice powers?
But, like, you don't... you don't think about... I don't think about this too much, but it's like, how would that... Like, how would you concentrate that? I mean, obviously, it's like... You can't. Like, he can, but I can't.
I mean,
not that I know of.
Have you ever tried?
No, but it's like, how do I know how to try?
I mean, just try.
Like, I would just push
like,
and, like, imagine
like,
ice out of
you
my
know what?
Hands?
Like
how
I
do I focus?
I kind of feel you on this one, because I'm like, you know what? Maybe I just do have superpowers, but, like, I just haven't committed enough to do it, right?
Oh, shit. There's just... I learned about this one. It's
Wait, so if you try hard enough, you'll do it?
I mean, I don't know. There's this one comic series. There's 6 issues, and it's called, like, The Worst X-Men Ever. And it's this, like, teenage kid whose, like, only power is that he has the ability to explode.
Yeah.
And, like, the explosion radius is so large that it can blow up a whole city.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh my god, that's amazing. And then, like, Beast is like, yeah, but you can only do it once because you'll kill yourself. He's like, oh, okay. And the whole comic is just him, like, being on, like, the X-Men team.
Yeah.
But, like, not being able to use his powers, so he's just, like, some human that's just, like, walking around with everyone. Some fucking guy. Yeah, and it's, like, you can't train that, because that's what I was thinking, too, right? Because it's, like...
Well, I mean, like, what if he's trying to do, like, little explosions?
Yeah, it's, like, how do you
train... Like, what if you just try to, like, blow off his arm, right?
Yeah, but then all of a sudden he blows up and, like, destroys the city, and you're like, oh, shit, I'm sorry.
Wait, is that how it ends?
No, he has a conversation with this guy who's also a mutant that bullies him all the time, that he has no powers and he's just bluffing. And they're on, like, a top of a building. He's like, you know what? Fuck you. And, like, grabs a hold of him and then uses his power and just, like, blows up a whole city. And that's the end of the series.
Like, what? What a fucking hero.
Like, holy shit.
Like, moral of the story, like, don't bully someone or they'll fucking explode. Yeah. Take the whole city with
him. He goes through, like, a series of, like, joining all the other teams, though. Like, he's on X-Force for a bit, which is, like, mainly, like, killing people, right?
That's yeah.
Yeah. But, like...
Yeah, it's, like, Cable and stuff.
Yeah, because, like, he actually gets sued as part of the X-Men, because, like, he was, like, being aggressive towards, like, a criminal.
Yeah.
And because law sucks, they're just like, yeah, you were mentally harassing someone. He's like, what the freak? So then they join X-Force, because he's like, oh, yeah, well, you can be violent there. But he can't use any powers, so he just, like, gets beat up all the time. It's, like, really sad. What are these women... These are freaky.
Yeah. They're like weird spider things. I don't know.
I mean, like, they're not doing much. You're screwing them up.
Also, like, this dude's just here.
That's important, isn't it?
It probably means, like... It probably means that, like, the church and this place are connected. Which, I mean, like, they kind of are. Because Pontius Shulvin is, like, the guy who runs the church. So it's kind of like... implying that.
Because, like, I've watched, like, videos on Dark Souls stuff, so I don't know if it's this game or another game, but, like,
yeah.
Possible spoilers, but, like, I know there's a boss that has to do with, like, worms or something. Like, I just remember that thing looks really familiar. Like, I feel like it's, like, part
Dark
of,
Souls
like...
Dark Souls 2 had, like, a kind of similar-looking thing.
It was, like, a final boss that did, like, a shit ton of damage, though.
It was, the Rotten. He was, like, a main boss.
That's probably what I'm thinking of. Worms are gross.
Yeah.
I mean, like, human worms. Especially human worms. But normal worms,
maybe, yeah. Too. I mean, I've never met a normal worm that I liked, so...
You've met human worms that are okay, though?
I mean, no.
Yeah.
So, we're kind of, like, at our cross here. Where we can go fight Pontiff Shulvin. Or we can go... to the Irithyll dungeon.
And we'll decide that next time?
Yeah. Yeah, we will.
Okay. Bye, right. Guys.
Bye, everyone.